Washington at a time in which people in this district get a chance to send a message to President Obama, a couple of really important messages, and they couldn't come any too soon. One is that we're spending way too much money. We've got to get control of our spending, that he's got to give us a realistic plan to save jobs, because so far everything that he's tried has been a failure. All he wants to do is continue to perpetuate the policies that he's followed in the past. And I think that our economy can't stand any more of this. Stock exchange is demonstrating that every day. The president put out a plan a couple of days ago saying he's going to save jobs. But we believe the plan. We're not investing in America. We're in New Jersey. We'll try to find a nice way to say this. Warm build is still. It's basically all the same things he tried for the past. Payroll, extension of the payroll tax credit, you can extend it again. It'd be a nice thing to extend the payroll tax credit. It didn't work for a year and a half. How the heck is it going to work now? Nobody believes it'll work. He wants to see if he can extend unemployment insurance. That's a very humanitarian thing to do. In fact, I don't necessarily oppose extending unemployment insurance. Extended already, and all we've seen is a decline in jobs. So why would you think that extending unemployment insurance will provide more jobs? If I go on and on, but I'm not, I think the stock market is giving the answer. The plan doesn't work. We need to send somebody to Washington who is going to send a message to President Obama. We've got to come up with a new plan. Somebody like Bob, been an enormously successful businessman, understands the private sector. Well, that's exactly what we need in Washington, not another career politician. Not another career politician who doesn't have no idea that I've ever heard, except repeating the same mistakes in the past. Also, I know a major focus for everyone is the economy and the lack of jobs, and the fact that the president has had the worst record in job creation of any American president in my lifetime. There's also the issue of foreign policy and the issue of Israel. And there's no question that President Obama needs to be sent a very strong message that he can't consider the Palestinian Authority in Israel as moral equivalent. We made this mistake in the past when we've always had a tremendous problem. The president seems to consider that the Palestinian Authority should be given more consideration, more benefit, more concern than the state of Israel. And that makes no sense. There was an article in the paper today that if we don't allow a Palestinian state, if we don't allow them to vote on it, we'll lose an ally. But it's the Palestinian Authority and our ally. I don't remember a treaty with them. I don't remember ever there being on their side. I remember Palestinian terrorists killing Americans, but I don't remember Palestinian Authority being our ally. Nor, for the life of me, can I figure out what benefit there is to the United States to have a Palestinian state. Why would America want to create another terrorist state? Here's when you create a Palestinian state. When they convince us that they have completely conquered terrorism. And that they're not going to generate people in their schools that are taught every day to hate Americans, to hate Israelis, hate the English, to kill Americans, to kill Israelis, and to kill the English. Why would we want to be part of establishing another terrorist state? We have too many terrorist states. We're seeing real difficulties with Syria and Iran. Why should we create another haven for terrorists? The Palestinian Authority has to convince us and Israel that they can be peaceful, that they can accept the right of Israel to exist as a Jewish state, and that they can conquer terrorism within their own country and not be a breeding ground for terror. And, you know, if we would stand up and say that clearly, precisely, and unequivocally, that would be probably the biggest step we could make toward peace, the biggest realistic step that we could make toward peace. A longer time ago than I'd like to remember, when Marsha Kramer was only about 12 years old, I threw Arafat out of the United Nations. A long time ago, back in 1995, and I was condemned by the White House and the New York Times, gosh, everybody, for doing it. Here's what I said.
I want water.
You were propping up a man who was a murderer, a killer, an assassin. And it was an unrealistic policy that he was following. Arafat had no interest in peace. I learned a lot of that when I investigated the case of Leon Klinghoffer when I was United States Attorney. And we're making the same mistake again. Somebody like Bob can go to Washington, clear ahead of him. Rather than somebody like his opponent who has a willingness to follow, I think, anything the Obama administration wants them to do or say, I think it would be like a wake-up call to the Obama administration to have a realistic policy about the Middle East, particularly about Israel. Israel is our ally, not the Palestinian Authority. Israel has legitimate concerns with their safety. And the fastest way to peace in Israel is to be realistic and be honest, not to fall for this romance of the Palestinian state, which until they demonstrate they can be peaceful, it's not good for us, and it's not good for the peace movement. So I'm for Bob Turner. I hope that he gets elected. I think it will send a very powerful message.